Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're talking about the best of the best. So before we start the video, as usual, please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more my face every day. Well, not every day, but anyway, don't forget to hit the little bell and follow me on Instagram as well if you want to see a bit more of my life, of my vlog, of blah blah blah, whatever. So in today's video, I was just like randomly reading some articles in Fragrantica the other day. And you know, Fragrantica, which is our little bible, I would say. But yeah, I was just reading some article about that, and I just remember there was the Fragrantica Awards that are done since 3 years now, I think, in the website. And I was like, oh, this is quite cool. So I had a little read quickly, and I was like, maybe I should like give my first impression of, because basically in the Fragrantica Award is the readers that are deciding, so you can vote up to 5 fragrances in each category, I think. And then this is quite cool because it gives you what are the trends, what people did really appreciate last year. And I'm doing this video about 2019 choice actually, because I don't know when they're gonna launch the 2020 awards, and I can't wait. So at least with this video and the other one, we could do a little comparison. So I wanted to have a little read today, so it's gonna be like very chill. I didn't prepare anything. I remember reading the position a few months ago, I think. So there's nothing planned. I'm just gonna give my first impression. It's gonna be very quick as well because we have 3 categories to go through. There's the best perfume for women in 2019, best perfume for men in 2019, and best perfume unisex for 2019. So it's gonna be very quick. We'll try. We're gonna start by the best perfume for men in 2019. Best of the best of 2019 was Ombre Lever from Tom Ford, which I'm really happy about, to be honest. I don't know if you did like it, but I really did like this type of laser, slightly spicy. I mean, you've got that special DNA, like very ambery from Tom Ford, which is absolutely amazing. But yeah, the leather is very different, and you've got a touch of flower, I think, as I remember, that is beautiful. The second position goes for Bleu de Chanel Parfum into... Why do I read the date? So you know, you had the Eau de Toilette, the Eau de Parfum, and the Pure Parfum now. And I did really appreciate this new version from Chanel because it's got a new accord, which is cedar sandalwood, and I do absolutely love this because it looks a bit more sensual, oriental. But if you would ask me to choose between the three, I would always go for the Eau de Parfum because I think it's a good balance of everything. You've got a touch of fruitiness with grapefruit, a touch of woody notes. But I mean, like for more wintery and more like mysterious vibe, the Bleu Parfum is beautiful. Anyway, I need to talk less. Then we have in third position Terre d'Hermès Eau Intense Vetiver. I do still prefer the Terre d'Hermès Eau de Toilette, so the classic, but I did really love this. I think it looks very earthy but still very uplifting version. I don't know, what did you think about that? Oh yeah, by the way, please don't hesitate to send me what you think about the stands. Would you put the same fragrance as the best fragrance of 2019? Anyway, I think I'm not going to read the 10, I'm going to read the 5th position all the time, otherwise it's going to be a nightmare. And then we've got Armani Code Absolute Giorgio Armani. So I think I didn't try this one. What did you think about it? Because I remember the Armani Code that I did really enjoy because it's got that warm deepness, slightly spicy, that is beautiful. The Armani Code Flanker usually I really like, so I need to try this for example. But tell me how it feels if you did try it. And then you have the rest of the top 10, which is Y Yves Saint Laurent, Montblanc Explorer, Montblanc Explorer that I resented more recently because of Steve from Factory Cheese, because he did really appreciate this fragrance, and I did quite like it as well. I think it's a really nice daytime. In fact, it looks like a Invictus, but Invictus. it looks a bit like Creed Aventus, but I think, I don't know if I prefer this, but I did really appreciate this one. Luna Rossa Sauvage Eau de Parfum. This Bois Mystérieux from Guerlain, that is so nice. Let's go for the next category. The next one will be the top 5 of the best perfume for ladies. So let me see. What is it? Is this there? So the best perfume for ladies, so let's stick to the 5. The first position goes to Mont Guerlain Eau de Parfum Intense. I heard a lot about this fragrance and I'm sad because I don't really like it. I think, I don't know, usually I'm saying, oh, it's not really for me or stuff like that. This one, I find it very like, there's a touch of amber, quite oriental notes in there as I remember. But it's really too sweet. Like, it's really too sweet. It's too feminine. Like, I mean, it's maybe not for me because it's I don't know, I find it too sugary. Then the second position goes to Coco Mademoiselle Intense from Chanel. That's a good release. I always appreciated the juice of Coco Mademoiselle Classic, but I was not really the best fan of it. But the Coco Mademoiselle Intense, I have to say, I love it. Because basically you've got still this touch of orange, jasmine rose, but the trail changed, so you've got vanilla, amber accord, so it gives a lot of sensuality to the fragrance, but without skipping the fruity and freshness uplifting notes. So I did really enjoy that, and it doesn't smell like really sweet. It's really much more sensual, mysterious. I really did like it. But usually I really like the new interpretation of Olivier Poch fragrance apart from his dad. But then the third one is again a Chanel. It's Chance aux Tendres Eau de Parfum. This one I did really appreciate as well. It's been very popular, definitely. The Chance aux Tendres Classic was my favorite, though. I still would go for that because it's got that grapefruit quince accord that is really like uplifting, vivid, delicate, powdery with touch of white musk. The Chance aux Tendres got more roses, and that's maybe why it's not really the best for me, because you know me, the roses is not my stuff, but yeah, it's really nice still. And then Pure Musk for her, Narciso Rodriguez. I'm really happy about that. I'm like, wow, because I love musky fragrance because they're very powdery, cottony, things like that. And as I remember, this one is like full on musk, so it's extremely powdery, but when you smell for her the classic, it does smell very powdery as well. It nearly smells like a I don't know, like a, how do I call it, you know, a cashmere hoodie or a cashmere top, you know, jacket or whatever, but something, or a cashmere scarf. Like, it's so elegant, powdery, delicate. I love this fragrance, so I'm really happy to see it here. Then we have the fifth of the list is Nomad from Chloé. I remember it smells very mossy, and that's why I think the philosophy of the fragrance is quite nice, because it's called Nomad, so you're supposed to like smell a lot of landscape and things like that, which I did really like, and it doesn't smell too much on the flowery notes. It's got a lot of like citrus at the beginning, so it's quite nice, good balance. Chloé, for me, they always do like very classy and elegant fragrance, but not too strong, not too much, very romantic, bohemian kind of feeling, so which is really lovely. And then what we've got after, just to have a little look, Delina from Parfum de Marly, Lib from YSL, Coromandel, a pure parfum. If you love Coromandel classic, the pure parfum is just absolutely stunning. It smells like a cake for me, like a cupcake at the beginning, and oh, and then this oriental accord, I mean, I love it. Right, so that's it for the ladies. Let's see for the best unisex perfume of 2019, what is the fifth nominees? The first one, Coromandel Pure Parfum. We were talking about this. I do absolutely adore this. The classic was like a lot of vanilla bourbon, frankincense, you know, feeling a bit churchy, but not too much. It's not like a Tom Ford that's gonna be like extremely oriental, very like incensey. Like this one has got like a touch of it. Lots of benzoin as well. So if you're looking for a true oriental, this is what I mean. And the Pure Parfum's got really like a, I think, I don't know, I can smell more patchouli in there. And when I first smelled it, I thought it was like a bourbon cocktail or something like that. And it's really nice. And I've tried the extrait de parfum on my pulse point, and then I sprayed the parfum all over. Yeah, I know, I'm crazy. And it lasts on me so nice. Just even a few drops in there and I could really smell it. It's just... Anyway, the second unisex is Ombre Leather. So we've been talking about it in the first one. I'm not surprised to see Tom Ford and Chanel over there. And then we have a Christian Dior Fève Délicieuse. That is such a good gourmand. Like, as a gourmand fragrance, you know, like, I'm usually... not the best fan of gourmand fragrance, but this tonke bean inside is so nice, and the vanilla is not too sticky as well, so it's lovely. Some caramel as well, so you feel like very warm, sweet, without being too tacky. And then, oh, a fourth one was Bois Mystérieux from Guerlain. And that, I'm like, it's funny because I've been on a consultation for Guerlain, and they analyze, they've been analyzing, anyway, you understood, and according to my taste, Bois Mystérieux was the favorite one for me, and I did really enjoy it, but I found it, I was surprised how it was leathery. I was not imagining that leathery, so you can really smell that skin scent. But the myrrh inside, like very like an early like kind of Egyptian feeling, you know, was delightful. And then we have Encens Mythiques by Guerlain. But I have to say that the exclusive fragrance, or just saying, my favorite exclusive is Bois Santal, but I will definitely do a video because I've been some people asking for me to talk about Guerlain more, and I will do a video on it, so no worries. I did really like it. Mémoire d'une odeur by Gucci in 6. I don't like this. Annie from Nichen. That I tried recently, I did really like it, but again, I want to do a video about that, so I'm not going to spoil anything here, and it's not a deep conversation we have right now. But yeah, so really interesting, isn't it? So let's see if the 2020 is going to change, or what is it going to be about this year, and blah blah blah, but I thought it was quite nice. There's also the best niche perfume. We can kind of see the same arriving. Oh, best perfume bottle. This is quite nice as well. 14 minutes, that's fine. Best perfume bottle. Oh, there's some that I have. Fantasia Mehmed Anna. Oh, there's another one like this. Fantasia Classic. So cute. So cute. But I've done a video on it as well. What I can see really is, if I'm looking at all the perfume over there, is you can see a lot of... designer and mixture of designer and niche in the best perfume for women and men, which is really nice because it means that we're getting more and more educated about fragrance, we're more curious to discover other things that are not in store, but we see that the same leaders are always over there, which I mean Tom Ford, Dior, Chanel, Guerlain, YSL, but yeah, these ones are always here. But I mean, it's a really qualitative houses, it's long time houses as well. When you look at their history, they've been there since years and years, so I'm not really surprised of this top, really. I was really expecting it. And when you're like an Instagram weirdo like me, like, and you're browsing constantly on fragrance on Instagram, you can see those bottles constantly arriving. My best surprise, I think, was the Narciso Rodriguez Musk in the fourth position, because I was like, oh, it's a fragrance that I did really enjoy this year, but I didn't know that it was that popular, so I'm really happy because it's such a great fragrance. But yeah, so that's it for me today, and I will see you soon in another video shortly. Bye bye now. I saw you on the street.